Hello everyone, Dev Victoria is here, and today I'm going to show you how I made the slingshots working. So basically the slingshots are rubber bands on basically three pins. I put these two extra pins here because if the ball is hitting these rubber band, so if the ball is hitting the rubber band, it closes a circuit, and these two things mark the spot where the sensors are. And then there is a thing here which is going to push out the ball, hit the ball, to make make the ball go away. And this is what we have to simulate. Obviously, in Unity there are no soft body simulations, and it would be quite complicated anyway. So what can we do? Fake it till we make it. And so I set up a slingshot here, and this slingshot has a physics shape, which has a capsule collider here, and this is going to raise trigger events. So if the ball is hitting this, then we can detect that. There is a slingshot model here, which I had created in Blender. We have a mesh collider just to make sure that the balls are can collide with this mesh. This is a convex hull mesh, just to make sure that the ball cannot go through, not even if they are coming from here or coming from there. We do have a sling. This is this has a kinematic physics body and a box physics shape with some bevel in it. And this is what is going to go out in order to hit the ball away. And we do have a sling target. Basically, this is similar what we had implemented for the bumpers, but instead of vertically, this sling empty is going to move horizontally forward. So in order to make that working, the only difference is that we have the trigger on the slingshot, so we have to invoke the animation system on a different target. So for that I introduced a kinematic animation target data ordering script where we can tell that we want to animate the sling in fact. And the sling has a kinematic bumper data ordering which has the starting empty and the destination empty and the time to reach the destination. So I think that was it for the editor part. Let's see what kind of code do we have here. We have the kinematic animation target data, which is going to edit to the entities, and basically if someone specifies a game object, we are going to get the entity for it by invoking the conversion system getPrimaryEntity method. The kinematic bumper data ordering that is in here, we had already talked about. I haven't changed anything about that. So let's see the trigger sling animation system. This is going to trigger the kinematic animation on the target entity. Very similar what we have already, we collecting the kinematic bumper state data, the ball tags, and the kinematic animation target data. The kinematic bumper state data is writable, the other two is readable. And the job we have here, we are detecting which entity has the kinematic animation target and which entity is the ball. And we are making sure that we are only executing these things if one is the ball and the other is a kinematic animation target. And we are getting the animation target from the kinematic animation target data. And if the kinematic bumper state data group has this animated entity, meaning the target that we specified has this kinematic bumper state data group, then we are going to get at this kinematic bumper state data, and if it's in the idle state, we mark it as that it should transition to the destination. And the bumper animation system is just as we had before. So let's see how this is working in the game. As you can see, this collider is moving forward and it is going to push the ball away, which is quite cool. But what can we do about the rubber band shape? Because obviously when this thing pushes out in real life, it's going to change the rubber's shape. So we are here in Blender now, and I would like to show the shape keys I had created for this slinger. So we've got the basic where everything is fine, and we've got this out shape key, which is this rubber band is a bit more forward on this side here, comparing to the basis shape. And I created an animation where the where this rubber band is moving forward and backward, and I had exported into the FBX file. The most important thing that you should uncheck the NLA strips and the all actions. This is how it worked for me, actually. And this is how I exported everything. And after I had imported this in Unity, you had to make sure that it uses a skinned mesh renderer and it has these blend shapes. And if I move this slider, then you can see the rubber band is moving. And the trick is that when it comes to Unity dots, as far as I know, this thing is only working if you are using the universal render pipeline. But in the Pinball Bench mention, we are already using that, so that's not a problem. You have to create a special shader graph. This is not complete yet. Later, I guess I have to add parameters for the base color and the normals and so on, etc. But what is the most important thing? You have to have a compute deformation node in the shader graph and connect it to the position, the normal, and the tangent values there, like this. And once you got this, then you have to create a material which is using this shader graph. And then you have to assign this material to the slingshot. Unfortunately, this makes it disappear from the workspace in the editor. But don't worry, it is going to be visible when the game is actually running. And also, how can we make this animated? I also created an animation target data authoring script, which is going to invoke playing an animation clip on this animation target, which is now is the slingshot. And onto the slingshot, I added a rig component. The bones are set automatically, and also an animation clip data ordering script. I created a simple sling idle animation clip. This animation is like totally empty. It's very easy to create. And also the scene animation comes from the exported slingshot animation. Basically, if you can see, now the rubber band is moving back and forth. So this is what I added to the slingshot itself. Let's see what kind of code I had created to make it work. The animation target data authoring is similar to what we had before for the kinematic animation target data authoring. It has an animation state data, and also we have this animation clip data. I guess I talked about this for the first bumper animation video I had created. So this is all the same. Nothing has changed here. And also there is a trigger sling animation clip system. This is totally similar what we had seen before for the trigger sling animation system. We just using the animation state data, the ball tag, and the animation target data, and we are going to do the same thing. And also I talked about the animation clip setup system for the bumper. This is exactly the same thing. I haven't changed anything in it. And the animation clip play system is exactly the same as it was before. I haven't changed anything on this either. So let's see how this is all working. I don't know if you were able to spot this, but the rubber band has actually moved. Let's turn off these. As you can see, it moved a bit. As you can see, the rubber moved a bit. So, I think that was it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. And see you in the next one. Goodbye for now.